Good evening, children. Today we are going to discuss regarding the topic relations and functions, which is the first topic of Standard 12 course. So it is covered under the unit that is relations and function. It consists of two chapters. First topic is types of relations, which is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, and together they are called equivalence relation. We will discuss regarding this. So today we are going to cover that. Before covering, let us have some preliminary idea regarding a relation, what we have studied regarding relations. In relation, we always have an ordered pair. So when we are defining any of the relation, so it is a subset of A cross B, we say. When we are talking about A cross B, so A cross B, it is always in the form of ordered pairs. So ordered pair means, suppose I have x comma y, it is called an ordered pair. Why ordered? Because first element belongs to the first set and second element belongs to the second set. So when I am defining any relation, we are saying it is either a set containing one pair or two pairs or three pairs, but all should be part of A cross B. For example, I take suppose set A as A comma B, that is a relation in fact. So when we are talking regarding writing set, so we should not put ordered pair there. Now A comma B, and B is a set having the elements 1 or 2, and we have A cross B, and A cross B is nothing but A comma 1, A comma 2, B comma 1 and B comma 2. So you take either any one element out of them, or you take two elements, or you take three elements, or you take all four elements, all are called relations. So if I define a relation R1 and I take the elements 1 comma 1, this is also a relation. If someone wants to take, no, I will take two elements, suppose A1 and B2. In that case, it is also a relation. So many relations I can define. Now here a popular question comes on this topic. Suppose A has m elements and B has n elements. How many relations can I define from A to B? So first, you know, A cross B has mn elements, and if a set has p number of elements, then its number of subset becomes 2 to the power p. In that case, number of subset becomes 2 to the power mn. So each subset is called a relation. Hence, each subset is a relation, then every relation is defined as each subset or any subset. So hence, number of relations is also 2 to the power mn. So in this case, we can define number of relations as 2 to the power mn. Now let us have some more idea regarding, we are having two sets. First one is called A, second one is called B in this case. And suppose I have elements called A, I have here A, and suppose B, this is having 1 comma 2. I define a relation A relates to 1 and A also relates to 2. So my relation here will be defined as A comma 1 and also A comma 2. And as we have known that the elements which are covered in the first set, they are called min, and the elements which are covered in the second set is called the range. So these are some of the preliminary idea regarding the relations, and here we are going to find or know about types of relations. In types of relations, we come first we come across reflexive relation. So reflection, this word has come from reflection. Reflection means the image should be itself. That means if A relates A, then that relation is called reflexive. For example, if I say define a relation congruent to, if I say triangle 1 and here I put triangle 1, is this statement true? That is triangle 1 congruent to triangle 1. This statement is true, hence the relation congruent to is an or is a reflexive relation. Similarly, if I have the relation R and it is defined as 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3, that is, if I map the relation like this, first it will be 1, 2, 3, here it is also 1, 2, 3, 1 relates 1, 2 relates 2 and 3 relates 3. So this relation, I can't say it is reflexive. That means, if A relates R for every A which belongs to the set A, that is, R is a relation from A to B. But if someone tells that it might be possible that 1, 1 in this case and 2, 2 are present, is this relation reflexive? Let us map that. 1, 2, 3, here also I was having element 1, 2, 3, I am having 1, 1, 2, 2, here 1 has its own reflection, 2, 2 has also its own reflection, but 3 doesn't have its own reflection. So here that relation cannot be said as a reflexive relation. So not reflexive relation. So now let us come to our symmetric relation. In symmetric relation, I think the symmetricity should be followed. So when we say symmetric or something is symmetric about something, in that case, suppose, let us recall, regarding your triangles. If I say A or triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, let us say, can I write in that case triangle PQR is also symmetric to triangle ABC? I think yes. Hence, that relation will be called as a symmetric relation. That relation means you are similar to. Right? Similarly, if I have a relation called brother of, if I write A is brother of B, in that case I also write B is brother of A. Okay, you may ask that sister is also possible, but here brother, sister, since they are having the same parents, so in mathematical sense, they are the same relation. So brother, if A is the brother of B, that means A and B must have the same parents. Similarly, B is the brother of A, that means B and A are having the same parents. So this statement is true, hence we can write they are also symmetric relation. Now, in some cases, the symmetricity sometimes holds or sometimes doesn't hold. For example, if you write if the relation greater than, suppose important relation, it is greater than. If I write an element A is greater than B, can I write B is greater than A? So this is false. So that relation is not at all symmetric. So now let us talk about the last kind of relation, which is the most important one. Generally confusion also arises sometimes. That is transitive. That means we transit the properties from one to other. If A relate B and B relate C, this is requisite condition, three elements are required and two pairs, A should relate B and B should relate C, then A should relate C. So that type of relation is called transitive relation. For example, if line L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3, can I write L1 is parallel to L3? This statement is yes. Hence, that relation parallel to will be called a transitive relation. But in other hand, if L1 is perpendicular to L2 and L2 is perpendicular to L3, so I think it is wrong to write always L1 is perpendicular to L3. Not always. Because they can be parallel also. For example, to have a demo, let us have this one. These are three lines I am drawing. This is L1, this is L2, and this is L3. For L1 is perpendicular to L2, it is true. L3 is also perpendicular to L2, it is also true. But L1 is perpendicular to L3, it is not true. So here, that relation is not at all transitive. Now, when, it is very important thing, one concept, that when all the three things they hold, a relation which is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. All the three things, if they hold, then they are called equivalence relation. So, let us solve or deal with some questions or test some questions. Okay. So, for that, let us go to the book, NCERT book. Now, we are having this book. Look at this. Determine whether each of the following relations are reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. A is having the elements 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 14. R is x, y such that 3x minus y is equal to 0. So for this type of things, we have to map it and then see whether they are equivalent or not, or symmetric, reflexive or not. So our given relation is, if I see, set of all xy such that x minus 3y equals to 0. Let us have a verification of that. Sorry, it is 3x minus y equals to 0. So 3x minus y equals to 0, our relation is, hence we are going to write that 3x minus y equals to 0. And our A is containing the elements 1 to 14, I think. Yes, it is 1 to 14. So A is having the elements from starting from 1 to 14. 1, 2, 3 up to 14. Okay. Now, in general, you just pick this statement, and for testing reflexive, you replace y or the second number by x. So now the relation with 3y minus x will be 0. Sorry, it is for transitive. You replace y by x. That means wherever y is there, you just find or replace it by x. So 3x minus x equals to 0. My question is it true for all x? I think not, because it is true only when x equals to 0, because this equation actually 2x equals to 0, and if 2x equals to 0, then x equals to 0. Hence we are having this reflection. So let us map 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is up to 14. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 14. Now see, thrice of first minus second, this relation all suggests us that thrice of first minus second equals to, you read it like this, thrice of first minus second equals to 0. So thrice of first minus second equals to 0, if I see these things, okay, thrice of first minus second equals to 0, is it? Thrice of 1 minus 3, thrice of first minus second equals to 0 if it is 6. So here I can see that one is not reflecting itself. Rather, one is one image is 3, two image is 6. So this relation is not reflexive. I think this is getting clear to you. Now, let's test the same result for symmetric. So we'll have number 2 test for symmetric. Our relation is x thrice of x minus y equals to 0. In symmetric, what we do, replace y by x and vice versa. It is a bit different from the previous one. Replace y by x, also x by y. That is 3y minus x equals to 0. And let us judge if this is true under that circumstance. You can I say that 3y minus x equals to 0? For example, our relation, in the relation, the element I got 1 comma 3. That means if I have 1 comma 3, I must have 3 comma 1. But if you see the mapping, 1, 2, 3, and it will continue up to 14, and here it was 3, 6, and this is 9. So 1 was reflecting to or getting directed to 3, 2 was getting directed to 6, and 3 will be getting directed to 9. But I need 3 should get redirected to 1. So here it is not possible, hence it is not symmetric. So always, wherever you get this type of symmetric situations, replace y by x and also you replace x by y and just the sentence. Now, let's test the same question for transitive. In transitive, we have always three elements. First one is for x, y, then you have create yourself y, z. For x, y, you create the relation 3x minus y equals to 0. And for y, z, you create the relation 3y minus z equals to 0. So, the required thing is here, thrice of, or required is your x should relate to z. That is, thrice of x minus z equals to 0. Now, let us judge. From these two statements, can I get a statement called thrice of x minus z equals to 0? Of course not. That means if I have first and second and third, I must also have first and third, so as to call the relation transitive. So the given relation was neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. I repeat, the given relation is neither reflexive, neither of three. Neither reflexive, nor symmetric, nor transitive. So, now, let us solve another question. If I ask you to test the relation parallel to, right? For reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. For reflexive, you take two random elements. That is one random element only, A parallel to A, and judge whether it is true or false. Of course it is true, because two lines are said to be parallel if they are having the same direction cosines. So if I find the direction cosine of line A and line also line another line A, then that is true. Next, transitive or symmetric first. If symmetric, that is A parallel to B, can I write B parallel to A? So this is also true. Hence this is reflexive. And number 3, for transitive, you create 3 elements, for A parallel to B, B parallel to C, then A parallel to C. Now let us judge. If A is parallel to B and B is parallel to C, I think it is A parallel to C is true. Hence this is an equivalence relation. Why equivalence? Because it is symmetric, transitive, as well as reflexive. Now, the last question, let us take it. I will give a relation R, set of all xy such that x minus y mod is divisible by 3, and R is a relation on set of integers. So here, number one, I will prove it is reflexive or not. For reflexive, I have asked you that replace y by x and rewrite the statement. X minus x, because I should not write y now, is divisible by 3. So it is true, because 0 is divisible by all numbers, so hence it is reflexive. Now let us talk about symmetric. Symmetric is swap the places of x and y. First statement is x minus y is divisible by 3, and the second statement will be y minus x, because I am swapping y by x and x by y, is divisible by 3, and the statement is true, because x minus y mod is equal to y minus x mod. In modulus, they are the same thing. So if one is divisible by 3, the other one is also divisible by 3. Number 3, transitive, we have to create 3 elements. X minus y is divisible by 3, y minus x is also divisible by 3. Okay, so we are writing here, suppose x minus y equals to 3p and y minus x equals to 3k. Because it is divisible by 3, I can take it like this. Now you just y minus z, it is, so you just add. If I add, I get x minus z, it is equal to 3 whole into p plus q. It is also divisible by 3, so that means x minus z mod, right, x minus z mod is divisible by 3. So all the three things are satisfied, hence it is equivalence relation. So this is all for today's lesson. Like this you can prove many questions on equivalence relation. So I am showing you some of the questions, and you try to solve them of your own and ask your doubts. So this is first topic of exercise 1.1 NCERT. You will get many questions to test symmetric, transitive and reflexive. So that's all. Thank you. And for just solve the questions, and whatever doubt you have, just discuss it in the next class. Okay, thank you very much.